Last lecture, we have discussed about Bohr theory as well as emission spectrum. Every element has a unique spectrum which you can use to identify the element. For example, the first one is hydrogen spectrum, second one mercury spectrum, and the third one is neon. And the complexity of the lines will depend on the number of electrons of each element. As we have discussed yesterday, the lines are produced due to the photon emitted by the relaxation process of the electron from excited state energy to ground state energy, or from higher level energy to lower level energy. This is Rydberg equation. The Rydberg equation can be used to calculate lambda and frequency, to calculate the properties of photon between the two lines involved in the transition of electron. So this is Rydberg equation, 1 over lambda equal to Rh, which is Rydberg constant. N1 is the initial quantum number, and N2 is the final quantum number. So when the excited electron in the hydrogen atoms return to the lower energy states, they emit photons of certain energies, and the lines here represent the energy due to the transition or movement of electron. Now look at the question. What is the wavelength of light emitted when the hydrogen atom's energy changes from N equal to 4 to N equal to 2? From here, we can identify the initial quantum number, okay, is N equal to 2, and the final quantum number, which the electron excited in 2, is 4. And we can put in the values into the Rydberg equation. And from here, you can calculate the 1 over lambda, and after that, you can calculate lambda. During our last lecture, we have discussed the concept of quantization of energy. So again, here, if you can imagine that the turtle is an electron, you can see here, if the turtle is at certain staircase, means the turtle is having that particular energy, specific energy, compared to if the turtle is on a ramp, okay, this is viewed as continuous energy. We also have discussed Niels Bohr model, and Bohr proposed the electrons move around the nucleus in fixed path or orbitals like planets moving around the sun. There are still some limitations for Bohr's model because it only can describe or explain hydrogen atom or any system that has single electron. We also have discussed that according to classical physics, electrons or photons or any matter is viewed or perceived as particle. But the truth is electron, photon have duality or have wave particle duality properties. So a new theory called quantum mechanics is needed to explain the phenomena of this wave-particle duality. Here we have de Broglie equation, and de Broglie suggested that the wavelength of a particle of mass, regardless if a bulky mass, big mass, or sub-micro particle mass, can be calculated using this equation, lambda equal to h over m times speed. If we use the de Broglie equation and try to calculate the wavelength of a heavy object, you can see that it has a very heavy object have a very short wavelength that their wave properties go unnoticed. This can be viewed in one of my tutorial video on de Broglie equation. Tiny particles with small masses have long wavelength, so their wave properties are significant or important in part of their behavior. Schrodinger was the first one to successfully apply the concept of wave nature of matter to electronic structure. And he has come up with what we call as Schrodinger equation. So Schrodinger is the one that starts to consider the wave and the wave property of electron. Based on Schrodinger equation, the wave functions for electron is later known as orbitals. Now look at orbital concepts. Okay? Orbitals are characterized by a set of three quantum numbers. N, which is the principal quantum number, L, which is a secondary quantum number, and it is also called subshells. ML, magnetic quantum number, which divides the subshells into individual orbitals. So these are main three quantum numbers. And you can see here, let's say if you have one S, means that the N is equal to one, L is n minus 1. You can see L is 0 and ML for L is 0 is also 0. So 1s orbital can be described, okay, by using electron in 1s orbital can be described by using these three set quantum numbers. Okay, let's say if we have electron in 2s. So the first, we have to look at the what is the N, okay, the shell. So 2s means that N is 2. And we know S, okay, L for S is 0. Okay. ML for S is 0. Now we look at electron in 2p. Okay. So 2p, 2 of course, the N is of course still 2, but P is represented as 1, as the subshell. So subshell for P is 1. And the ML for 1 can be represented with negative 1, 0, and 1. So let's look at 3s again. 3s, the main quantum number is 3, and equal to 3. Since it is s, L is equal to 0, ML equal to 0. Now, if we look at electron in the 3p, so n still is 3, L equal to 1, because p will be represented by L equal to 1, but ML for 1 is negative 1, 0, and 1. Now, let's say if we look at 3D, okay? So, 3 is an N is 3, okay? But L for D is 2, okay? Now, the ML for D starts from negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. It's easier to remember because if it is 1, it starts from negative 1, 0, and 1. And if you remember that the p orbital have 3 orientation, okay, the p orbital is dumb. The shape is dumbbell, okay, and the position is it has 3 different positions or 3 different orientation. So if you look at here, s orbitals are symmetrical, spherically symmetrical. So that is why it has only 1 orientation, and the ML is 0. P orbitals are dumbbell shaped. Okay, here we can see P orbitals, and P orbitals have different orientation. That is why the ML, which represent the orientation, starts from negative 1, 0, and 1. That represents the different orientation of p orbital. Let's look at d orbital. Since d orbital has 5 different orientation, if you remember, ML for d orbital starts from negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. So there are 5 suborbitals for d. So you can see here, each electron, okay, in the orbital can be described by using a set of quantum numbers. For example, electron in 1s orbital can be described by having n equal to 1, l equal to 0, ml equal to 0. Now, we have maximum, 1s can have maximum of 2 electrons. So how do we differentiate the 2 electrons? By having additional set of quantum, which is ms. Okay, so ms represent the spin number of the electron. Question related to quantum numbers will be shared in the tutorial video.